Hello. Blind Pew here. Ancestral Blind Pew. The year is 1899 and I've arrived here in the Wild West, or to be specific, in the charming town of Armadillo in Chala Springs. It's been some time since I've visited the town, and as a one-off, I thought I'd take a look. As ever, I'm joined by Ben Gunn, my chief of operations, but he is currently back at camp. In this journal that you are reading, I intend to chronicle my adventures. Anyway, after a long ride, I need a quick drink in the saloon.
Nice to see your face again. I figured you'd be long gone by now. Anything I can do for you?
Yes, a cup of tea, please.
Whiskey.
Or whiskey, then. Good lord, serving it by the bottle, I see. Oh well, when in Rome. That certainly had an invigorating effect on me. I don't like the way that chap at the end of the bar is looking at me. I also don't like the look of what I assume is a bounty hunter at the table behind. How dare you say tea is an unpalatable drink? Take it back, sir.
This town may be going to hell, but this fool sure ain't. Now behave.
I had to put him right on that. Now, where did I put my hat? Ah, there it is. Still don't like the look of that person at the table. I'd better get out of here before the law take an interest. That's not it. Ah, here we are. Unfortunately, someone has reported the fracas back in the saloon to the law. I'd better get out of sight until this thing blows over, as I've had a few run-ins with the law before. They found me. Hey you there, it was just a disagreement about tea. Yes, tea, I say. Seems they are not of a mood to discuss it. Aggressive negotiations it is then. And anyway, they started it. This chap's a bit far off for my cattleman revolvers. Luckily, I recently invested in this bolt action rifle. Sterling, the law are coming in thick and fast now. Need to reposition. I'm saying that hat shot was on purpose. Definitely not a miss. Definitely. Okay, so the battle has raged all night and we've reached the morning. The law are still surrounding the town and coming in fast. I need to get to ground level and consider a way out of this predicament. Perhaps this dynamite I have on hand will help. Hang on, that's a bank right by the side of me. Gives me an idea. My honor levels have taken a terrible hit anyway, and I have this dynamite. Why not blow the doors off and rob the bank? You know, back in the day I used to regularly rob this bank with a chap called Marston. Here we go. Untold riches for the taking. Oh, no effect. Seems they reinforced the doors since last I was here. Cribes. The law just keep coming, and the bounty on my head keeps going up and up. It has reached $10, so standard bounty hunters will be after me soon. Need to reload. Rather exposed, calls for desperate measures. I'm taking a bit of a beating here. Need to regain higher ground. Never could reach this balcony last time I was here. Again. I'm claiming that hat shot us on purpose. Well, my honor level has now hit rock bottom. It is fair to say this disagreement about the merits of tea as a drink have rather spiraled out of control. I'm sure the good people of Armadillo, who I have been very careful not to involve, would, nevertheless, like to see the back of me. I need to get to lower ground and find a way out. Preferably not like that though. I've temporarily pushed the encircling law back beyond city limits. But it doesn't last. Look, Pinkertons are coming now. You can tell by their long coats. Will this madness never end? They just keep coming. I need to come up with an innovative way out of this situation before the bounty on my head becomes unmanageable. Oh no you don't, my good man. No flanking. Right, got to get out of here. Dusk has settled, and I caught this lawman trying to sneak up on me. I've an idea.
I'm gonna cut you down!
I've tied him up in the middle of the street to draw his compatriots out and finally finish this. Unfortunately, I've mistimed it, and a couple are left behind that wagon over there. Well, I've a surprise for them. I have a few of these fire bottles. Here we go. Oh no. How unfortunate. Don't let that happen to you. I must say that smarts a little, but it seems I'm still alive. So here we go again. I'm really taking a beating here. Need to just stay out of range for a few seconds and find a way out. If I can just clear the law from the southwestern side of town. Be careful as my bounty is over $20 now. So I may get elite bounty hunters, or players, as they are known after me. Just spotted one in my scope briefly there, but he was not after me. Time to make my escape, I think. Ah, I hear the train arriving in the station. If I can just steal a horse and calm it down in time, a daring escape may be possible. This will do, I think. Hey, calm down there. Got to time it just right. It's now or never. Made it. I'd better get up front and deal with the driver. Don't want him slamming the brakes on. Out you go, my good chapter. Bon voyage. Sound the whistle and off we go. Thundering down the tracks at full speed. They'll never take me alive. Jumping off with the train still moving, whilst no one sees me. And off into the wilderness. Free. We've escaped. Although, with a bounty this size, it was always going to happen. Elite bounty hunters, or players, as I call them, have hunted me down. Can I survive? They're encircling me. There's one. Engaging. Shot from behind and in front. Super accurate too. Good show. Can't complain. Although, they've collected my bounty and that hurts the bank balance. I may have to turn over a new leaf. Like starting a thriving trader's business with Ben Gunn, my chief of operations here, back in my camp. Although, he insists on using his middle name now. Crips. We turn materials, animal carcasses, into goods for sale, with the addition of supplies such as tanning chemicals and the like.
Gonna be out of supplies before too long.
Ben Crips Gunn tells me we are running low on materials, so I've come up to the mountains here, far from civilization, hunting the elusive cougar. These are great materials for our business. If I'm not mistaken, that one has a pelt in perfect condition, 3 stars. That is worth a lot for our business. I'll just take it back to my hunting wagon, and I'll send the hunting wagon home. I may see if I can catch one more cougar and take it home on my horse, but I don't like staying out in this area too late, and it is getting dark. I got the cougar, but I've left it too late, and the wolf packs are out. Heading home now risks attack by the pack. I'll try and sneak to the top of this outcropping to see if I can locate them. Well, I can't see them, but they sound to be all around. I think I'll risk it. Need to ride fast. Oh cripes, that was a cock up and no mistake. At least my horse has not died. I need to get this cougar carcass loaded back on before the wolf pack realizes. It's all quiet at the moment. Hello. Got to go fast. This horse is quite skittish and will butt me off if wolves get too close. Look, they are coming in from the right. Faster. Got to get clear. Ugh, who are these guys in the way? They should act as useful bait to lure the wolves away. Yes, look, the wolves are going after them. So, back at camp and I can hand all these carcasses over. Unskinned perfect ones are the best. And look, we now have a full stock of materials. What do you think, Ben? Crips?
Supplies are good. I'm a happy man.
I see. But we seem to have run out of supplies like tanning chemicals and the like. What shall we do about that, Crips, Ben?
Alright, time for a little lesson on supply and demand. Now, when group one, us, has a demand for supplies, and group two, them, has said supplies in their possession, how do we rebalance the economy?
I see.
By robbing them blind, of course.
I understand. You didn't need to be so obvious. Off we go. Need to get in quick. Take the supply wagon and get out. They seem to have their own personal army here. 1, 2, and 3. Not actually sure the 3 was involved, but no matter. 1 left, time to go in 6 shooters blazing. Embarrassingly inaccurate. That's got him. Now which one is the supply wagon? No, not that one. Yes, that's it. Back to camp full speed. See that chap in the wagon ahead? That is another trader, or player, as I call them. Normally I would be wary as rival traders can disrupt each other's business, but he looks to be collecting supplies just like me. Need to get this back to camp before the chaps I stole it from come after me. I spoke too soon. I'll take the closest out with a shotgun, and outrun the second. The other one is still gaining. The bolt action rifle will deal with him. Hey, time to get this back to camp. Here you go, Crips Ben. Got the lot.
Nice work.
Okay, so what does this mean? Well, we've got full materials and full supplies, so it is now down to Ben Crips Gun here to grind out the finished goods. He can grind out 100 before we need to deliver. The question then will be, whether to make a safer local delivery, or a more lucrative, but risky long distance delivery. We will see, but that is another story. Until next time. Good luck, partners, and I'll see you out there.